Very good morning. I hope all of you are fine and also taking rest. Meanwhile, we can see that lessons also. So, I think 24 members are enrolled this particular course. So, this course actually it's a combination of seed science and economics. So, that seed science part I will take care. The economics part of this particular course will be taken care by the Dr. Selvam, Professor of Agriculture Economics. So in the theory, they given the aspects related to that regulations, seed sales related regulations, and what are the agencies involved in this particular seed marketing, then a agency with reference to international level, agency with reference to that national level, that is India level. Apart from that, that organizations directly and indirectly connected with the seed production, seed quality regulations, and international seed movement. So all those things we will study in detail. And then other than that, seed production planning and material related to that establishment of the seed testing laboratory, seed processing unit. So all those things we will study. Finally, as an outcome of this particular course, you are going to prepare a project, and that project should be a worthful one. If you submit that particular project in the bank or any loan giving agency, they have to accept that one. So that much level of proposal you are going to prepare, that is ultimate aim of this particular course. So in this particular section we can discuss about that Indian seed sector, the present status and the trend and opportunities. So this is actually it's a world growing population level and the food demand. So we are aware of that, the people, the population are increasing, and side by side that food requirement also keep on increasing. So here that projection is given for the different food grain and their requirement for the year 2000 and 2030. Say the pulses that requirement is for the year 2000 14 million tonnes, but the quantum of material required the year 2030 will be 30 million tonnes, like that for each and every crops that is given. Here the problem is that grain production area is keep on decreasing, whereas that demand for grain is increasing. That is a problem. The other end, that consumer, that population also increasing. So with the level of whatever that land is available, we are in a position to increase that productivity and the production of our food grains. So for that purpose, that seed going to play a major role. So that is a thing. So we need seeds. So this is a global trends, that market advancement and forecast for 2024, and seed industry in the overall the global level. So mostly that Canada and North American countries, India, China, these are all the country there that seed industry is growing like anything. Whereas in the case of South America, like Brazil and African country, that the growth rate of seed industry is less, because now only they are getting into the agriculture, and also particularly the African people, they mainly they are getting their seed from the the North American countries and European regions. So they are not that much with reference to that seed production and seed industry related business. They are not yet getting into that. So this is overall scenario with reference to that seed industry and their role at various country in the global level. This give you some idea regarding that on the growth rate trend of the seed industry growth. So normally that if you compare that seed industry and the trade, with 1994 to present trend. So currently that seed rate increased to the level of 7x. Normally we will use, and we use that x and all for preparing the solutions. So example, you may studied in the seed science, that is electrophoresis, sample paper preparation. We may use 1x, 2x, 3x, 4x. 1x means diluted one, so right concentration, that is used for conducting the test. Suppose if you wanted to have a concentrated solution, means we will go up to 5x. 5x means much more concentrated. So that 7x means 7-fold increase was recorded on the seed rate, the global level. This is mainly because the people aware the usage of quality seeds and their impact in the agriculture. So because of that, the seed trade and the seed interest is growing like anything. And also, the export value also increasing, so that international seed sector export value is somewhere around $11.9 billion. So that much quantum of business run by the several countries in the name of seed business. And another thing is 15% of the industries, whatever they are getting through that seed rate, they are investing 15% of their profit for R&D purpose. So with that level of investment, now we are getting so many number of high yielding varieties and hybrids. So this percentage is increased to the level of the 30% or 50%. We will get more and more number of useful varieties for cultivation purpose. Definitely that will fulfill our food requirement, food grain requirement. Similarly, you can see that export also 3.9 million metric tons of seeds were exported globally the year 2017. 3.9 million metric tons of the material. The another main thing is that 17 sustainable development goals actually adopted by the UN, the seed industry contribute to a majority of them, such as no poverty, zero hunger, food health and decent work, economic growth, industries, innovation, infrastructure, all these things responsible for consumption, production and climate actions. So these are all the things said by the UN. So majority of them are fulfilled by the seed business, because no poverty means here if you are able to produce more food grain, means there won't be any poverty, there won't be any hungry. And if you supply food material, automatically health condition also being maintained. And also the development of the seed industry, that will give you job opportunities for more number of people directly and indirectly. So decent work will be given automatically once that industrial setup, industrial kind of setups are getting into that agriculture. Automatically there will be a more industry. So industrialization leads to that increase that income generation potential of the country. So a lot of innovation will come, infrastructure also will develop. So most of the goals set by the UN is fulfilled by the seeds. Another main thing with reference to that seed business is concerned, international seed federations, they are the voice of the global seed sector. So they are regulating the seed trade and seed movement at the international level. Actually 75 countries were the member of the International Seed Federations. So all of them are jointly, they are growing, they are exchanging and they are actively participating in the seed trade operations. Actually that ISF, International Seed Federation, started in the year 1924 in the name of Seed Trade Federations. Later this particular federation was merged with the Association of Plant Breeders, that is ASSINSEL, in 2002. At the time only they renamed as International Seed Federation, ISF. So 7,500 number of seed companies are involved in the ISF through membership in national level, national seed and trade association. Apart from that, small and medium enterprises and family business, international companies also cooperating. and also they are engaged breeding, production and trading operation. So ISF play a major role at the international level, particularly the seed trade related activities. So these particular slides give you a clear cut idea about who are all the major players with reference to that seed economy is concerned. So in that case, that India also got a place 13th or 14th position with reference to the domestic seed market value in terms of million US dollar. So 2000 million US dollar worth business is taking place in the case of India. In that case, that USA is ranked first, second one is China, then France. So total world seed market is approximately 45 billion US dollar. India is the fastest growing seed industry in the world. The compound average growth rate is 17%. This is a very good sign as far as that India is concerned. So now we can see that quantity of seeds produced by the public sector and private sector over a period of time. If you compare that availability and requirement, the year 2008 and 9, that availability of the quality seeds is 2.5 million tonnes, but originally they demanded for 2.07 million tonnes, so excess production was there. Out of this 2.5 million tonnes, and that public sector contribution is 60.2%. Out of 2.5 million tonnes, the private sector contribution is 39.8%, the year 2008 to 9. But over the period of that development, that private sector, they take an upper hand. They are contributing more towards that seed production when compared to the public sector. Particularly that private sector, they are concentrating the seed production in the case of vegetable crops and agriculture crops. In the case of maize and cotton, they are concentrating. So over a period, that recently that contribution from private sector is keep on increasing. So based on the available data, the year 2017 and 18, that original requirement was 3.71 million tonnes. Material made available to the cultivation is 4.19 million tonnes. Out of 4.19 million tonnes, 57.28% was produced by the private sector. So the public sector contribution is 42.72%. So this clearly indicates that seed production and seed sales is a very good income generative process. Again, another thing also very very important, the first slide itself I told you, so that seed is the main input. So by the way of using that quality seeds alone, we can maximize the productivity and production of our country. So these particular slides give you a clear cut picture about that, clear cut justification for that particular statement. So in the case of in the year 1980 and 81, the quality seeds availability is 35 lakh quintals. At the time, that procurement production is 129.59 million tonnes. The year 2018 and 19, the availability of quality seeds for cultivation is 398.87, that ultimately get reflected in the procurement production also. So 284.95 million tonnes. The same thing also get reflected in the oil seed production and pulse seed production also. So this clearly indicates that the seed, quality seed, is the only option available with us for increasing the production productivity of our country, not only our country, even the entire globe level, because most of the country, they are facing the problem of the cultivable land shrinkage. So that keep on decreasing, the demand is increasing. So under that situation, we have to increase the productivity. So for increasing the productivity, we must rely upon the that quality seed material. So actually, this is a seed supply system in India. So this particular by following this particular system only, we are producing a different class of seed material. And that previous course itself, you people are given with enough idea with reference to different classes of seeds, who are all responsible for production of different classes of seeds and their purity level, all those things. Anyhow, I wanted to recollect all those informations so that for seed production purpose, we are following that generation system of seed multiplications. So in that generation system of seed multiplication, that always start with nucleus seeds. The nucleus seeds will be used as a source seed for the production of the bedder seeds. Again, that bedder seeds will be used for foundation. Then foundation will be used for certified. That certified seed is distributed for grain production. So this is a generation system of seed multiplication. Again, that nucleus seeds also production is resist with the institute from which that particular variety was released, or the person who developed, the breeder who developed that particular variety alone is empowered to produce that nucleus seeds. So again, here there won't be any seed certification program, there won't be any tag. So here that things, everything need to be maintained. So you may aware of that. The breeder said also no certification, that one not comes under the certification program. Again, that is produced by the only by the public sector unit, like that state agriculture universities or ICAR institutes. Then remaining two category, foundation seed and certified seeds, that comes under the seed certification scheme. So that normally that ADA seed certification is responsible for monitoring of the seed production activity in the field level. So that the ADA extension or the seed growers, they normally act as a cultivator and producers. So by that way, that system is getting operated. So here that seed supply system. So I already told you that ICAR Institute or State Agriculture University alone is responsible for production of the breeder seeds. Whoever need breeder seed for foundation seed production purpose, if it is a national variety, they have to place their intern through the Seed Federation of the India. So in India, we have a Seed Association of India is there. So through that, we have to place the intern to the Department of Agriculture and Cooperation. It's a ministry. So there we have to place. Suppose if it is a state variety, say example, a company like Rossi Seeds, they are in operation in Tamil Nadu. They wanted to multiply that public sector variety, that is a TNAU released variety in the form of foundation seed, means for the producer seed requirement, they can directly place their intern to the state agriculture university located within that state. But if it is a national variety, they for producer seed purpose, they have to place their intern to the Department of Agriculture and Cooperations. After receipt of that intern through that Seed Association of India, Department of Agriculture and Cooperation, they will send all the details to the ICAR. Again, ICAR in turn will communicate the data to the Indian Institute of Seed Science, that is located in the MAVU. So after receiving all these intern, that Indian Institute of Seed Science, they will allot that breeder seed requirement to the concerned institutes. So based on that intern received from the IISS, that the concerned institute will start to produce that breeder seeds. So after production of that breeder seeds, that institute will dispatch their material to the concerned the intender. That mostly for foundation seed production purpose, for foundation seed production taken care by the National Seed Corporation. Then State Farm Corporation of India and State Seed Corporations. So these are all the main agency. Apart from that, ADA extension also eligible. Then registered seed growers also eligible. So they are, and also these particular agency alone is responsible for working out the seed multiplication ratio of the crops and seed replacement rate, all those things. So SRR and all we can discuss later. So here they will produce that foundation seed. So by that way, produced foundation seeds will be distributed to the interested person for certified seed production purpose. So finally, whatever that certified seeds are produced, so those seeds will be distributed for grain production purpose. So this is a seed supply systems we are following in India. So here that main role played by the ICAR, they are playing a main role. So for ICAR, that IISS, that is Indian Institute of Seed Science, previously it's a Directorate of Seed Science, that is located in Mau and Uttar Pradesh. So they are coordinating. So they are the coordinating center with reference to overall breeder seed production of our country. So I wanted to recollect one information. If it is a national variety for breeder seed purpose, we have to place our intent to the Department of Agriculture and Cooperation Ministry. So that ministry again will send that, they will consolidate, they will send the requirement details to the ICAR. ICAR again send the matter to the Indian Institute of Seed Science. So Indian Institute of Seed Science, so based on that requirement, they will allot the breeder seed production to the concerned institute. So this is for the national variety. If it is a state variety, so that whoever need record that breeder seed, they can directly place their intern to that particular institute. Say example, Rasi seed need MC5 cotton seed, means they can directly place the intern, breeder seed intern, to the TNAU. So this is for the state variety. Okay, so this particular system we are following with reference to seed supply in India. So this one is a recent happening in the case of seed related thing. So that is a new seed bill. So here a lot of changes going to take place. Actually, this is a proposal again placed in the parliament for approval. So here they given more weightage in such a way that, so we are going to adapt, or we are going to change our seed testing protocol little bit. So previously we are checking the germination, physical purity and genetic purity and moisture content of the seed alone for giving a tag, either foundation tag or certificate tag. But in the case of seed bill, we are going to insist checking the seed health status of that material also, because if you want to export your material to other country, that exporting, that importing country, they are demanding for the seed health report also. So under that situations, we have to verify our seed materials are free of any pathogens or insects or any weed seeds and all. So that is very, very important. So all those things and all incorporated in the seed bill. So once this particular bill is accepted and we are going to adapt this kind of serial test and other recommendations, our material also ready for export to the other country. But now with that level of whatever that right now we are following, with that level of testing, we cannot export our material to the other country. So that is an issue. So that one we are going to once this particular bill is accepted, so we can seed testing protocol, there will be a changes will happen. So I wanted to give you some information regarding that export potential of India. So here you can see that export potential at global level, and there are Indian contribution also in various segments like vegetable crops, flower crops, field crops. Say example, the global level in the case of vegetable crops, 1,14,661 metric tons material is distributed. Out of that, Indian contribution is 3,544. This is vegetable crops. Similarly, in the field crops, and totally 44,35,089 global level, that seed movement. Out of that, our contribution is 29,177. That is a total metric ton. Our contributions, the value also you can see that quantum of seed handle and their value is 11,378 million US dollar in the global level. So Indian seed value is only 83 million US dollar. So if you compare it to global level, our export potential is, seed export potential is less than 1%. This should be increased more than 5% or 10%. Definitely we will get more income out of this particular business. So for that purpose only, now we are started to do some revamping work in the seed act and the seed testing protocol and all those things. Similarly, that seed import share of India. So here you can see that the quantity, metric tons and the value. So here also 107 million US dollar, and that the global level it's 10,954. So here also you can see. Then top seed export destination in world level. So mostly, most of the seeds, 57% of the material, vegetable crop seeds, that export destination is the Asian countries. And only 23% Europe, North America 12%, and South America 0.5%, Africa 6%, others 1.5%. The major export destination is the Asia with reference to vegetable seed crop is concerned. Similarly, in the case of field crops also, 70% they exported to the Asian countries. So America only 7, Europe 7, Africa 16, South America nowhere in the scene. Asian market top export destination for India with reference to India, yeah, we are also exporting our material to the other countries. Particularly we are exporting majority of our material to the Philippines in terms of values. Next to the Philippines, so this is Asian. Similarly for SAARC nations, we are also exporting. So there we are exporting more amount to the Bangladesh. Next to Bangladesh, that Thailand, then Pakistan. So these are all the export destination for India with reference to seed is concerned. So we are exporting our material only in and around that country located nearer to our countries. So what may be the reason? If it is a classroom, I can ask you somebody to stand up and tell. So now the problem is I cannot do like this. So I hope you find out the reason. So because here the thing is that whatever that material, whatever that variety or hybrids are available with us, everything is suitable only for the tropical climate. So wherever the tropical climate is there only we can export our material. That country alone will import our material, because the country like Europe or South America or North America, the temperature and the climate prevalence is totally different. So because of that, they never show any interest towards import of our material. That is the problem. So if you want to have a very good business, seed business means we have to produce a variety. We have to strengthen our R&D. So by the way of strengthening the R&D, we have to target various countries. Accordingly, we have to develop a variety. Variety suitable for the tropical countries, variety suitable for the temperate countries. Like that, once you started to develop that kind of things, you will be the leader. So here that clearly, so this particular slides clearly shows that one. Because that we are exporting our material only to the Asian countries and SAARC countries, particularly Bangladesh, Philippines and all those things. So that is a problem, and because of that only we are getting a lesser amount of the money through seed business. So we have to work for development of a variety that's suitable for all sort of a climate. At the time definitely we can get more amount of a income through this seed business. So leading crop segment in export from India. So here again, even though we have more number of crops and their seed material, out of that we are exporting more amount of the cotton seeds alone. So we are exporting 36%. Our export consists of 36% the cotton seeds and vegetable 16 seeds, rice varietals is only 13%. So hybrids, if you take that hybrid, hardly we are exporting 8%. Our export out of 100%, 8% of them are only hybrids. So like that, our major component is a cotton. So if you consider that the total seed export 100%, out of 100%, 36% in the form of cotton seeds. Country-wise export share of vegetable seeds from India, here that Bangladesh is a leading. Then next to Bangladesh, then Pakistan 5.8. Here you can see that some of the vegetable seeds also exported to the USA, and some of them to the China also 0.7% they are receiving, and Japan also 1.5% they are receiving some vegetable seed material. Again, I wanted to give you another one important thing. So this particular area, so Africa, mainly they are importing the material from the USA and Europe, but the performance of that material is very, very poor. Here also I wanted to ask you why. Even though they are getting a material from developed countries, the performance of those material is not good. Why? So again, here the thing is, in Africa, the tropical climate is prevailing, but they are receiving the material from the temperate countries like US and Europe. So because of that, that material performance is very poor. This is a very, very potential area for the India. Once we started to export our material to the African country, definitely our material will perform very well, and also we can convince the Africans. By that way, we can export our material also, and also that African also will enjoy by the way cultivating on the climate specific material. So in the upcoming years, for export of our material, Africa will be the better destinations. Apart from that, SAARC nations and the Asian countries. So this actually it's against a contribution made by the formal and informal sector. Formal sector means that private and the public sectors, and informal sectors, namely informal sector and the farm saved seed material. Again, the farmers will use their material. So those material, the quality criteria and all not fulfilled. So here you can see in most of the cases that formal sector contribution is increasing. That is a very good sign. But in the case of a ragi, that informal sector contribution is more, 66%, and wheat also 61.6%, and chickpea 77.6%, and adabean 69, and lentil 85%. So these are all the negative thing as far as that productivity of our country is concerned. So that things need to be changed. So once that formal sector distribution or contribution is more in all the crops, definitely that seed replacement rate will increase, and the protection also will be increased. So this need to be strengthened. The rape and mustards, the formal sector contribution is almost 90%, so very good sign. And paddy also 81.4%, it's also a very good one. So that contribution from the formal sector should be increased. So this is a contribution made by the formal sector and in informal sector in different crops. In the case of a formal and the cereals, informal sector the contribution is 46%, and this formal sector 54%, and pulses the informal sector is more, and oil seeds informal sector contribution is more and formal sector contribution is less. So these are all the public and private seed sectors is in operation in India. So for commercial seed production purpose, the public sector sites, we have a National Seed Corporation. Apart from National Seed Corporation, 15 state seed corporation also there. Apart from that, 114 number of ICR institute, research institute also responsible for production and distribution of the quality seeds. Then totally 73 number of agriculture universities, central agriculture universities, steam universities consists of 73 numbers is in operation. They are also involved in the quality seed production distributions. Apart from that, for ensuring the quality and the entire India, we have a 145 number of notified seed testing laboratory. I wanted to tell you one more thing. So in India, Tamil Nadu have more number of seed testing laboratory. I think this is somewhere around 42 or 43 number. I'm not sure about that number, but Tamil Nadu have more number of seed testing laboratories when compared to rest of the states. Then apart from 145 number of notified seed testing laboratory, we have one central seed testing laboratory that is located at NSRDC, National Seed Research and Training Center, located at Varanasi. So that is serving as a central seed testing laboratory and also serving as a referral laboratory. Another central seed testing laboratory also there. So that is located in the Central Cotton Research Institute, Nagpur. So that is responsible for monitoring the quality of the PT cotton alone. So even though this is also a central seed testing laboratory, but that is responsible for checking the PT cotton quality. So this is with reference to that public sector seed sector. Whereas at private seed sector, we have 50 large national multinational companies and 500 number of small players also there. The private seed sector, normally they are 15% of their allocation for the R&D and the production marketing, and 65% they are allotting for funding, and they are allotting for the marketing purpose, 20% for production marketing. So 550 seed companies are there in India. In India, I already told you, we are exporting seeds. Out of that, cotton is the main thing. So that India valued 420.6 million USD in the year 2018 through exporting. So the average growth rate is 7.8%, and we are the largest producer of the cotton seeds, major producer of the cotton seed. The production is 18,530 million metric tons in the year 2017. In 2018, cotton export were valued to 1.2 million US dollar. Mainly our export destinations are Sudan, Myanmar, Estonia, Ethiopia, Hong Kong as a major that export destination. Gujarat is the leading states with reference to that cotton production is concerned. So these are all the seed sector penetrations, hybrids, cotton 90 to 90% of them are hybrids. Maize 50% of the materials are in the form of hybrid. We are using paddy only 5%, vegetables we are using 70%. So in the case of cotton, maize and vegetables, that hybrids, they play a major role. So they are slowly replacing the variety, and most of the farmers also ready to take up that hybrids in the case of a cotton, maize and vegetables. So these are all the major players as far as that India is concerned. The private side, Navelo Seeds, Kaveri Seeds, and that the public sector side, that National Seed Corporation Limited, and then again that private sector side, Monsanto, PHI Seed Company, that is a DuPont Pioneers. So these are all the major players as far as that India is concerned. And then share of the public and private seed sector with reference to quality seed availability during the year 2017-18. In terms of lakh quintals, on the private sector, they are leading 57.28% contributions, whereas that public sector contribution is only 42.72%. So total quantum of material produced is 419 lakh quintals in the year 2017-18, so that the private sector contribution is more. Similarly for cereals, wheat and rest of the crops also. In the case of cereals, they are not concentrating that much. Public sector contribution is more, and in the case of that wheat, the private sector contribution is more, 63%, and rice public sector contribution is 47.5%, and overall cereals, that public sector contribution is more. But in the crop wise, the wheat and rice, the private sector, they are doing wonder. So this is referring to pulses, that public sector contribution is always more because it's a, this is somewhat risky seed material, and also it's a high volume and low value material. Similarly, that oil seeds also, oil seeds is somewhat equal, that private and public somewhat equal in nature. But previously, that oil seed and pulses, that farmers, they received contribution more from the public sector than the private. By these times, in the case of oil seeds, slowly that private sector also getting in. Actually, this particular slide is not clear. I can deal this one in later classes. So this is a varietal replacement rate. How often that farmers, they are changing, ready to change their variety. That is also very, very important, because every year we are releasing a new variety. That whatever that varieties are released, that varieties are always, and that varieties are superior to the previous materials. Definitely it's a improved material. Definitely by, if you cultivate that particular variety, you will get more yield. But instead of cultivating a new variety, the farmers cultivate only that old variety, means the purpose of releasing that new variety is totally collapsed. So that VRR need to be increased. So that assessment also made by the Indian Seed Science, Indian Institute of Seed Science. So that is given in the table. Here you can see in the case of rice, that number of variety that is available in seed supply chain, 293 number of varieties are ruling in India as far as rice is concerned. Out of 293 varieties, 68 number of varieties alone released within the 5 years period of time. But most of them are on the within 10 years period of time, 129. If we add these two, roughly that will comes around 200 number. Remaining 93 number of variety, whatever that variety, and that 93 varieties are ruling, all those varieties are more than 10 years old. This is not a very good sign as far as that production and productivity of our country is concerned. Similarly, in the case of wheat, a total number of ruling varieties are 158. Out of 158, 45 of them are less than 5 years old, 86 of them are less than 10 years old. If you add these two, that will roughly comes around 130. This is somewhat good, because 158 number of them are ruling. Out of 158, 130 or something is it's a recent one. So this is a very good sign. Similarly, in the PGNP, so 55 number of varieties are ruling. Out of 55, 8 varieties alone recently released within 5 years old, whereas 18 number of varieties are 10 years. I think most of them are more than 10 years old. This also not good thing. So similar kind of things. And rape and mustard also, 43 number of varieties are ruling. Out of 43 number, 9 number alone, it's a recent one, five less than 5 years old. 23 of them are 10 years. So this will comes around 32. So remaining varieties under very old. If you look at the groundnut, 46 number of varieties are ruling in India. Out of 46, 8 of them are less than 5 years old, 26 of them are 10 years old, 34 is somewhat 10 years old put together, remaining are more than 10 years old. So these things should be changed. So varietal replacement rate also we need to concentrate in order to increase protection and productivity of country. Again, that varietal mismatch. Varietal mismatch means, say example, I can quote that same example. Say example, Rossi seeds. and they wondered how they wanted to get into the foundation seed production MC5. Means they will place the intern to the TNAU for greater seed requirement. So based on their requirement, that a TNAU will take up a breeder seed production. At the end of the breeder seed productions, that Rasi seeds not ready to take up that breeder seed for foundation seed production purpose. So at the time there will be a mismatch. This kind of mismatch also there, not lifting of the seed material. Sometimes there will be a shortfall. All those things will be there. With reference to lesser mismatch is normally recorded in the case of rape and mustard. I will give you detailed explanation with reference to this one when we are meeting the classrooms. So OECD scheme, I can tell you on the separate session. This one also, I want to give you a piece of information. I will tell you elaborately about ISTA in a separate session, but I wanted to give you this particular thing. Even though in India we have more number of 143 number of notified seed testing laboratory, out of 143 number, the notified means that is a government undertaking notified by the state, the government. Out of that, only one seed testing laboratory alone is accredited with ISTA, that is Department of Seed Certification, located in Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu. That is the only public sector unit laboratory that got the ISTA accreditations. Remaining five of them also got accreditation, so all of them are a private sector. So we have only one public sector seed testing laboratory that got a ISTA accreditation. So if you want to export your material to other countries for export purpose, you have to check your seed quality parameters in the ISTA accredited laboratory. If it is tested under state seed testing laboratory, means you cannot export that material. So for export purpose, you have to get that international accreditation. So under this case, ISTA accredited laboratory play a major role. So this is a status with the status of the ISTA accreditation in India. So we have only six. Out of six, only one public sector, remaining are private sector. So totally we have 15 non-accredited laboratory, 8 public sector laboratories and 7 private sector laboratories. So these are the way I get. So I already told you, our newspaper cutting also I saw on. So that is a seed bill. So seed bill, we are going to do a lot of changes. That is change all those changes. Mainly we wanted to introduce for the purpose of getting a quality seed. All those seeds should be exported to other country. Through that we are trying to bring more foreign currency. So for that purpose, mere changing the rules and regulation of our seed testing protocol alone is not sufficient. We have to upgrade our laboratories that should match with the requirement of the ISTA. So then only we can get the ISTA accreditation. More number of ISTA laboratory, we can more sample analysis, more of our material get qualified, then maybe go to the abroad. Similarly, we have another international testing system, that is a OECD seed scheme. Another scheme also, our material will be test verified, that also eligible to go at the international level. So that also we have to work. So these are all the things we are going to discuss in detail in the upcoming classes. Thank you very much. If you have any queries, any doubt in this, you can send your brain back through the WhatsApp. Thank you.